Hello, welcome to 9design 3D. Let's make some Momiji type figure. Select our cube, Ctrl 2 for add subdivision surface modifier. Ctrl A to apply modifier and Ctrl 1 again, add another subdivision surface. Tap to edit mode and click the cage. S in Z axis. Z to wireframe, select half of the vertices and X to delete vertices. In object mode, add mirror modifier. O for proportional edit, and you can G to move your some vertices for making a head shape type. If your vertices aren't look good, you can select your vertices, right click and smooth vertices. Let's make body. Select bottom face of it, X to delete faces and E to extrude down. You can add another loop cut with Ctrl R and S in Y axis. Now you can move and scale your vertices and edges for body part of it. For making legs, select bottom edge line with Alt and F to fill, I to inset and E to extrude down. You can add another loop cut with Ctrl R. If some vertices snap together, it causes of the mirror modifier clipping. You can uncheck the clipping and scale your edges and vertices. After your job done, you can check your clipping again. Let's make ear, select a face on your head and X to delete faces. Select edge line with Alt again. E to extrude. You can go to front view with numpad 1. E to extrude your ears. After that, F to fill. And with the proportional edit, you can G to move. For making sharp bottom ear edge, you can add another loop cut for it. Let's make arms. Select two face of side part of the body and E to extrude. If it snap to the Z axis, for close it, you can press Z again. In front view, you can extrude, rotate and scale your arms like the idol figure. Let's make some hair. Numpad 7 for top view. Select some faces with C. You can select your faces quickly like that. With right click you can cancel. After that, select back part of your head. Shift D to duplicate, P for selection and select your hair and S to scale a bit. You can choose some edge lines and E to extrude. For making hair with a wavy look, you can close your mirror clipping. I will give some headband type of it. You can add another loop cut and give some shape. Use your proportional edit for quick result. Select bottom part of your hairs and E to extrude down for wavy look. If it's your edges and vertices not enough, you can add another loop cut with Ctrl R. A to select all faces of hair, E to extrude and right click, Alt S to scale. Our hair type is ready now. Let's make some clothes. Z to wireframe, select some faces of how you make the clothes will look like. Again, Shift D to duplicate, P for selection, and S to scale your clothes. If you want your clothes color opening, you can choose a vertices and G to move in Z axis. Select the bottom edge line and tie up your clothes and make longer a bit, like a dress. Again with A, select your all faces, E to extrude and right click, Alt S to scale. Let's make ribbon. For this, add a plane, scale, tap to edit mode, give some ribbon shape with your vertices. Select all faces with A and E to extrude in Y axis. Now we can add subdivision surface modifier with 3, shade smooth. In tap to edit mode, you can add some loop cuts and after that add mirror modifier and check the clipping. I to insert some faces of it, E to extrude in Y axis. For the middle part of your ribbon, you can add a cube. After that, give some subdivision surface modifier. Add some loop cuts for sharpie edges. Our ribbon will look like that. G to move, R to rotate and place it to your clothes. Let's make boots. Shift D to duplicate, T for selection, select your boots, A to select all faces, E to extrude, right click and Alt S to scale. If you want, you can add some species to your clothes. Select an edge line, Ctrl B to bevel, E to extrude, right click and Alt S to scale. You can add some loop cuts for your belt's sharp edges. You can make this for your clothes arm part of it. Let's make some hair accessoire. Choose an edge line, Ctrl B to bevel, Shift D to duplicate, P for selection, and select your accessoire. A, select all faces, E to extrude, right click and Alt S to scale. You can scale and move your hair accessoire for your head type. Shift D to duplicate your ribbon for your hair accessoire. Let's make eyes. Add circle. In tap to edit mode, select half of vertices, E to extrude, right click and S to scale. You can give some moon shape of it. And add subdivision surface modifier. S to scale, E to extrude for your eye. Scale, rotate and place it to your character's head. And add mirror modifier for make another eye. Let's make mouth. Shift D to duplicate your eye. Delete mirror modifier and scale it. Let's make cheeks and nose. Add circle again in top to edit mode, F to fill and E to extrude. Shade smooth and auto smooth. Shift D to duplicate your nose. For your cheeks. It's time to give some material to our character. First, give skin material. For cheeks, you can choose a pinky color. For mouth, I made this type of orangey color. For eyes, give some black color and decrease roughness. Go to Shading tab. Before this, go to Edit, Preferences, Add-ons and Node Wrangler. Write it, it will be active. Add gradient texture and add color ramp. Plug them each other. Choose your gradient texture and Ctrl T for mapping nodes. And add separate XYZ, connect Z to vector. We can add third color variation of your color ramp and choose your colors how you want. For clothes, choose same material and click New Material button. Change your material's name as a clothes. You can set different color to your clothes with the same gradient texture type. If you want to give different color to your belt and some other part of your clothes, you can add second material, choose your faces and assign it. or ribbon, we make same thing. Our character will be like that. If you want to get render in EV, check ambient occlusion, bloom, screen space reflection and refraction. In color management, you can set your contrast, medium contrast. Shadow, I made this 2K. Add a plane. In shading tab, to world section, you can increase your background strength and color. You can change it. Add different material for our plane. Set your area lights. And add cylinder. We will make round animation. Select your all figures parts and last selection cylinder. Control P. Object keep transform. Let's set some keyframes. Select cylinder, I, location rotation scale. Go to last keyframe in your timeline. Select cylinder, R, Z, 360. I, set another keyframe, location rotation scale. Our animation will be like that. Cylinder, effects, or figures, all parts. Thank you so much for watching. Please don't forget to subscribe and like the video. If I missed something, please let me know in the comments. See you later.